Okay. So first, we would like to thank you for spending your time to know the certification requirements of ASP as well as for CSP. Myself, Vignesh Gopi. So I'm a certified safety professional and a chartered member from IWOSH. And we are working in a team. We are supported by technical HSE experts from Facebook. So let us move on. So as you guys may be knowing, what is ASP and what is CSP? ASP is nothing but Associate Safety Professional from BCSP body. And CSP is nothing but Certified Safety Professional from BCSP. So first and foremost, we need to know where we are going to get this certificate and from which body. So both of the certifications are provided by BCSP. So where BCSP is located, it is located in US, and this certification body is going to carry out the exam for both of the certificates. So once you pass, they are going to give you the certificate. So once you receive the certificate, what it means? It means that you are a safety professional accredited by USA body. And this is recognized all over the globe, not only in US or not only in Europe or not only in India. All over the globe, these certifications are accepted by the companies or the organizations. Okay. So adding a note, we are giving guidance for ASP preparation, CSP preparation, and for the project works. You might be aware about BSC, British Safety Council, and the NIBOSH IDIP program as well. So we are supporting on their final projects. Okay. So now just have a overview of understanding what is the time limit, what is the exam duration, how we need to prepare for ASP as well as for CSP. Before going into this, first and foremost, the thing what you guys have to do is to know the eligibility criteria for this certification. It's not like NIBOSH or it's not like BSE, because this certification program is having a stringent requirement. They filter many professionals if they are not matching with the criteria. Even if you are 10 years or 20 years of experience, if you are not matching with the criteria, they will not take you or they will not approve the application. So what are those criteria? You can see or understand more by clicking or going inside the BCSP website and seeing the certification requirements. Okay, just have a understanding, this certification program, both the certification programs requires bachelor degree, and this is mandatory. Okay, and for ASP, 1 year of experience is minimum requirement, and for CSP, 4 years of experience is minimum requirement. So once you match with these two criteria, what are those two criteria? One is bachelor and another is experience. So once you match with this criteria, you can apply for the application. Okay, so let me walk through those things in upcoming slides. So have a understanding of exam pattern, how this examination is carried out for both the certification, for ASP as well as for CSP. There are only multiple choice questions. Okay, there is no theory writing. Only in a workman statement, I can tell it is obviously nothing but choose the best answer. Okay. So for ASP, they have fixed 5 hours for the examination duration. And for CSP, they have fixed the 5.5 hours examination period for a duration of the exam. Okay, so in between this time, there is no lunch break or there is no long duration break hours. So maximum you can take a break for 10 minutes. And this you can take n number of times. It depends on your health criteria. Okay, and for both ASP and CSP, there will be around 200 multiple choice questions. Okay, so out of this, for ASP, they have fixed 55% as a passing score, which is around 110 questions you need to do it correctly. And for a CSP, take it up 60%, it is obviously 120 questions out of 200. So these are all the exam criteria and how they carry out the exam. So during the exam, we have to follow these strategies, because you guys can see the overview of the syllabus by just going inside their website and having a PDF copy from the website. All the criteria and the requirements, what should be done, what should not be done, what are all the stages to take the exam will be mentioned. And it is not like a NIBOSH or like a BSc examination, just keep it in reminder. This certification will be taken directly from your end. There won't be any intermediator like the institutes what we have for NIBOSH and for BSc. So all those things for application and for eligibility criteria approval and for even choosing the exam center is in your hand. Where you want to take the exam, you can fix that. Even if you are in India, or by next 6 months you are planning to take the exam, if you are not in India, you can reschedule the exam as well. Okay, so all the flexibilities will be given to you, and you can decide what time you want to take the exam even, and you can reschedule it if it is not possible to appear on those dates. Okay, so let me walk you through the stages over here. First and foremost thing is completing the application. Where you will get this application? You need to enter inside the BCSP website, and likewise you are logging in for Gmail account. There will be a My Profile section inside BCSP. So you can click that and you can create your own account. Once your account is created, you can fill in your details inside the My Profile section. So it will be asking your full details, your personal details, your address details, as well as your experience details, all the stuff you need to fill it up. So once you fill this, you need to pay $160 to the board. Okay, as I said, there won't be any intermediate institutes. Each and everything you will be directly handling with the board. So once you pay this $160, I'm telling for both ASP and for CSP. Okay, it is different. First, you will go through ASP based on your criteria. You will pay $160 for that exam or for that application. Once you pay this fees, the board will approve you. They will take a review on your application. They will back verify your experience with your organization. They will back verify your degree with your university. So all these things they will do, and they will approve your application. So once this is approved, they will give you 1 year time duration to take your exam. Within this 1 year, if you are not taking, then again you need to pay the fees to get the approval. Okay, just have this in mind. Once your application is approved, then you need to pay exam fees to the board. It's around $350, and it is also separate for ASP and separate for CSP. $350 you will be paying to the board. Once you pay, they will give you the login and password to you in your mail ID, registered mail IDs, what you give in your profile. Okay, they will send the details over there, and there are only some of the few institutes or the exam centers available all over the globe. In India, I hope there is around 4 to 5 institutes for taking this exam. And for away from India, where you are located, you can check where it is available even. Okay, where you can check that, if you go inside Pearson VUE, and if you want to take the BCSP exam, you can check all the exam centers available in the globe. So you can choose only these centers for taking your exam. Okay. And the dates, exam dates, as I said before, you guys can fix the exam dates, which is preferable date for you. Because of this COVID, there are some extension of this 1 year period. Okay, because most of the institutes are closed based on the state government or central government requirements. So BCSP is giving some breathing time to take your exam as well. And each and everything will be notified to you through your registered mail ID. Just have a note, guys. These both are very professionals, and they have a tie up with most of the professional bodies in safety all over the globe. And we call CSPE certification is a golden certification in safety sector. Okay. And obviously, since they have all these credentials, and it is not very easy to pass the exam as well, and it needs a sincere dedication and time to clear the exam. And even if you want to know who are all have cleared the CSP certification, you can view inside BCSP website. They have posted all the names based on the country. You can view and you can know. Imagine, guys, we have 120 million population. Out of it, only 100 people are holding this certification in India. So by this, you can know how tough the certification and how valuable the certification is. Okay. So once you fix your exam, okay, and there will be a confirmation email from, not from BCSP, it will be from Pearson VUE. Okay, they will give you the confirmation email. Sir, you have booked the dates and this time, so please come with these following details. So what are all those details? Before going to exam, you need to take one address proof, original, okay, and you need to appear 1 hour before to have this verification. They will provide you with the policy, how you need to take up the exam, all these things they will brief you. So you need to appear 1 hour before. So once you take the exam, which I said 5 hours for ASP and 5.5 hours for CSP exam, and you guys can think that why, sir, it is around 5 hours and 5.5 hours, it is just a multiple choice question, why we require this much time? Yeah, from my experience, I am telling you guys, this won't be a very easy exam as you think. And in my experience, many professionals who we have trained, they have given the feedback, even these hours are not enough for taking this exam, because there will be mathematical part question, there will be theory part question, and there will be a technical stuff more for these exams. I will share you the syllabus for ASP and CSP in the same presentation what we are going through, and each domain will be having some weightage. For example, recent revision is being done by BCSP board for fixing the syllabus for ASP as well as for CSP. In that, they have fixed 9 domains for ASP and 9 domains for CSP. So each domain will be carrying out some weightages. I think you guys can see this now. The domains and the percentage weightage for each section. So this is the updated syllabus provided by the board for ASP as well as for CSP. The same details are available inside the website as well. You can go and view and have an understanding of the syllabus. Okay. So once you complete your exam, within 15 days, they will deliver the original certificate to your address, and there will be a renewal period for this certification. It's not like other certification. Each and every year you need to pay around 6,000 to 7,000 Indian rupee to the board to keep you validated for the next year. So those who are not validating themselves for the year, their name will be taken away in their website. Okay, just have this also in the in your note. Okay. Only one thing you can take inside, which is nothing but the approved calculator. This certification have fixed some of the calculators are only allowed to take it inside the examination hall, and which is nothing but Texas 30 XS, and these calculators are mentioned in the complete guide as well. But recently what they have done, this calculator they have built inside the computer itself, so obviously it is not necessary to take this calculator, but I recommend the professional to take the calculator because they have used this and they know how to use it very frequently. Without any time delay, they know how to take the answer from the calculator, because calculator saves more time for executing the mathematical part questions. Mathematical part questions, what I mean is not like simple addition and subtraction. It's like a standard deviation, variance calculations, coefficient of correlation calculations. So there are many technical steps over there inside the syllabus. Okay. So how you should prepare for this, if you guys are interested to take the certification, how you should prepare yourself? First and foremost is you need to approach a right candidate who can guide you. Right candidate, what I mean is those who have already cleared CSP and those who are having a valid CSP certification at present, because they are the only one can guide you correctly. They know how to prepare, they know what to read, they know the updated syllabus, so that they can guide you properly. Because many institutes in India, what they are doing is training the professionals without a valid trainer. What I mean without a valid trainer, those who have not at all experienced on, or those who have not cleared CSP, those who are not having a valid CSP certification with them. So first and foremost is to check whether the trainer is having a CSP with him. If not, just neglect the institute. Okay, don't go and trap with them, and they will ask more money for providing you the materials and for training you as well. And to add a note on this, we have trained a couple of professionals in India as well as in a global level, and we made them to achieve within 4 to 5 months. So let us walk through the points over here. Many can give you the feedback, no, it is not very easy to achieve. Many may give their own suggestions on this certification. Our guidance is to no need to do any hard work. Only smart work and self-confidence should be improved. Imagine guys, you some part of the safety sector or the portion you will be very strong, like risk management. But as per the domain, we should not be only strong on the risk management. We should be having knowledge on other domains as well. So we will first have a track record of the professionals, and we will focus on where you need to focus, especially to pass the exam. Okay. And there is no material directly provided by the board. You guys can ask, sir, I paid application fees, I paid examination fees to the board, why they are not providing any material? It is a policy with the board, they are not going to give you any materials to you. So that's why I am insisting we need to approach a right candidate or a right institute for providing all these steps. Because all these steps will be taken directly between you and between the board. So there should be some guy or some professionals to guide you accordingly what should be done and what should not be done, so that it makes your process very easy. Okay, there are too many resources available online, and it is not necessary to read all those resources to pass this exam. We know how to prepare smartly for this exam, and we know how to guide the professionals for this exam. So only that is much important. And adding a note, the one question which is asked in previous exam will not be asked in next exam, but the topic and the portions will be same, but the same questions will not be repeated. Imagine this is from the around 50 years back. So out of how many exams they may have carried out through online. If you see all the questions, even one questions will not be same. So imagine guys, how strong we should be on the concepts. We will provide important resources and the materials for preparing this exam for ASP as well as for CSP, the updated syllabus materials, what I mean. Concentrate only on the concepts you are lagging. So first and foremost, we need to know where we are lagging, whether we are lagging in system safety concept or whether we are lagging in risk management, which domain we are lagging. So first and foremost, we need to capture that and we need to start focusing on that. And we recommend professionals to read minimum 3 to 4 hours every day so that you can achieve or you can gain confidence within yourself within 3 months to face the exam. Okay, so this is all about this ASP and CSP overview, and hope you guys have just had some understanding of what is ASP and what is CSP, who's providing, what is the validity, and what is the certification weightage. And adding a note to certification weightage, all the certifications provided in India or Australia or in Europe or anywhere in the globe, CSP is considered as a level 9 certification. After this, you guys are ready to prepare for your PhD. So even the master's degree, the NEBOSH diploma or BSc diploma, all the certifications are level 6 when compared with CSP. CSP is level 9 and ASP is considered level 6 as well. So hope you guys had some frills on this certification. I can see a question. First we have to give ASP, then only we can give CSP, even if we have master degree and work experience with us. Actually, it's not in that way. What do you mean? Because some of the guys can directly take CSP. For taking that opportunity, our team will filter the requirements of the professionals. For an example, if I have RLI, because RLI is agreed by BCSP body, those who have RLI can directly appear for CSP. But some of the master's program in some of the universities are agreed by BCSP body to take CSP. For an example, you take Anna University, bachelor degree in occupational safety and health. So if you have done that program, no need to take ASP. You can just give a proof of evidence to the board saying that I have done this and I have filled my application and I have this much of experience. So I can take CSP. I am planning to give an attempt for Nipo Saidip. Shall I go for it or shall I go for ASP, sir? Actually, this is a very good question. First and foremost, you need to analyze yourself whether you are a bachelor candidate or you are just having a diploma or something. I recommend the professionals to take ASP if you are a bachelor candidate, because why I mean that 80 to 85% of syllabus in CSP will be covered in ASP. So it will be a better advantage for you to clear CSP in the first attempt, because you have studied most of the syllabus, which is around 85% in your ASP preparation itself. Then obviously you can deal with it. I hold a bachelor degree in mechanical engineering. Then obviously, Mr. Kamal, you need to go with ASP. That is the right way for you. Mr. Salil, how to find out by sending an email, like I had done my master's in HSC and I have work experience around 9 years. Good to know this. For this, our team is supporting to give you a feedback that, sir, you are valid to take ASP or you are valid to take CSP directly. For this, I recommend to send your updated CV to the mail ID what I am mentioning now, admin@hscheart.com. So if you send your updated CV to this mail ID, my team will come back to you stating whether you are valid for ASP or whether you are valid for CSP. As I said, only some universities or some masters or some certifications from India, they are agreeing for taking CSP directly. Okay, so even if you have done masters which is not approved by the board, for example, I have taken masters in some university and that university is not agreed by BCSP board, then obviously I need to go with ASP to take CSP. Okay, so this is how the step it is. Plus, I want to ask, like, formulas are given to questions which are like having calculations. To answer this, yes, formulas are given on the question itself, but our way of guiding the students is to know the formula by themselves based on the questions. If you are unlucky, then the formulas will not be appearing on the question. Then at that time, you can't ask the board or you can say why it is not given. So that's why we always suggest guys and we prepare guys to know the formulas and we give some mock drills or mock tests for them before taking the exam as well. I'm a recent graduate and I hold Nibosh IGC with credit. Good to know. I only have experience of 1 year as I do not have much experience. Will it affect my ASP examination, sir? Mr. Kamal, it is not like you should gain more experience to take this exam. First, we need to know your CV credentials, the full experience and the steps you have gone through so that my team can give better recommendations for you. I have BTEC, good. Jageshwar, I have BTEC, PDIS, Nibosh IGC, I am eligible for CSP with 9 years experience. We need to know where you have taken this PDIS, because this is post diploma in industrial safety. BTEC is agreed, that point is taken, but we need to see whether where you have taken this PDIS. So if the PDIS is valid by BCSP board, then you can go ahead with taking CSP directly, but before that we can't confirm. We need to know what stuff you have with you so that we can give more recommendations and the comments for you. So just to forward your updated CV to the mail ID what I have mentioned here, so my team will give you the feedback of what you need to do. Joe Matthew, sir, I have basic sorry, BSc I did mechanical engineering. Yeah, good to know this. Mechanical engineering degree will be taken by the board to approve you for ASP, but BSc ITIP is not agreed by the board for approving you for taking direct CSP. So for geomatu, you will be validated for taking ASP initially. Okay, noted, sir. I will share my CV with you. How much a program will cost and how those notes will be provided from your side. Each and every point you can mention in your email itself. What are all the queries you have? Just put on your email and forward your queries to the mail ID I have mentioned. My team will get back to you because each candidate will be different and each candidate holding will be different. And there might be a big question mark inside their head whether I am eligible or whether I am not eligible. So to clarify it, our team will give you the right feedback, which step you need to take ahead or which certifications you can move ahead to achieve it. So any further question, guys? Because I can't hear your voice. I can see only the comments and I can give the feedback for that only. If I hear your voice, it will be better, but it is not happening. No issues. Noted, sure, sir. Thanks for your feedback. Really appreciate your clarifying your doubts. No issues, Mr. Salil. Our team is purely backed up with many professionals who can give the right feedback because we know how the safety works in India and all over the globe. And to receive the right information, it is very difficult in, especially in our safety sector. So we are filling those gaps with the right professionals. So hope you guys enjoyed the session. So just had an overview of the certification. And thank you guys for your time. And I hope we will catch up with the next session if possible. Thank you. Or is there any feedback? Thank you so much. Thank you. I'll close up the session for now. And one more point to add it up to your note is that give your feedback on the Facebook pages what you have received, just to give your open feedback so that my team will look into it and we can see for the continual improvement how we can plan for the upcoming sessions. Thank you, guys.